You are taping.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نويت الأربعين، نويت الاعتكاف، نويت الخلوة، نويت العزلة، نويت الرياضة، نويت السلوك لله تعالى العظيم في هذا المسجد. We have explained yesterday two more of the bad characteristics that people are carrying with them through their selves. And we said that there are 17 main bad characteristics, that they are like trees of sins that Shaitan, Satan, and his devils are trying to play with us through different kind of bad desires in order that we will be falling, because this is their aim. What Iblis said to Allah, if you give me longer life, لَأَغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ, I will deviate them all, I will make them all astray.
لأغوينهم أجمعين إلا عبادك منهم المخلصين. أولئك إن المتقين في جنات وعيون.
So he said that I will take them astray, only those إلا عبادك منهم المخلصين, only those servant of yours, or those Ya Rabbi, even Iblis believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But he disobeyed. He disobeyed one time Allah cursed him. We are disobeying every day. How many times? Not one time. And Allah is merciful with us, because he was angel. He must not disobey. When Allah said to him, make sajda, he didn't make sajda because he was arrogant, kibar, he cannot accept it. So he said, I'm going to lead them astray. Only those who are sincere, means those who have been able to control their bad characteristic, or get rid of their bad characteristics, which are described 17 bad characteristics. And we explained how many of them? We explained 9 of them till now. So today, inshallah, we will explain, we try to explain al-batala wal-kibar. And we begin with the al-batala. In Arabic, al-batala is unemployment. When there is unemployment, some people have no job, jobless. We say a community, there is too much unemployment in the community. What happened when there is too much unemployment? What happened? Depression. Depression, you say? Depression, what you say when the economy goes bad, what you call? Recession. Unemployment lead to recession. And when it lead to recession, means you are not anymore active, means you cannot anymore produce something to pick up the whole community to a better life. That's unemployment. That is makes the recession. So the whole economy collapse. That is the same thing that is with us. When someone become unemployed, means as soon as you become lazy of following the Sharia of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, means the community becoming unemployed, becoming recession, everything goes down, means the whole mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has to to encompass us, because we are becoming, leaving the Sharia as if we are unemployed to that Sharia anymore. When you are doing your obligations, your prayers, as if you are unemployed, you are a servant. You must be employed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah employed us all. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لَيَعْبُدُونَ. Verily I have created ins and jinn only to worship me. Means you are an employee, we cannot say employer here, but to the creator. You have to follow what he has asked you to do. If you don't do that, he will kick you out, you become what? Unemployed. You become like, we become like Iblis. We become like ثُمَّ كَفَرُوا. And Allah say to us, ثُمَّ آمَنُوا. You are a Muslim, you are a mu'min. Be on the right track. So don't be unemployed. Don't leave my work and do the work of shaitan. Because shaitan said, Ya Rabbi, give me long life, I will take them astray. He begin with Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, but he was not able to come to Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu was salam. So unemployment, bitala or batala, is when Muslims leave the Sharia of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As soon as we leave our obligations, our foundation, the foundation of Islam will come down. Not Islam come down, but the community, the Muslims' power will be lowered. Why? Because we are leaving the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So unemployment from Islam lead us to employ, to be employed by Iblis. So following the bad desires is leaving, it is batala, means unemployed from good desire and running to bad desires. Running to dunya, leaving akhirah. So we are employed to dunya and unemployed to akhirah. We must be employed to akhirah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build us up. لا يغير الله ما بقوم حتى يغيروا ما بأنفسهم. Allah will not change what is problem on us until we change ourselves toward Him. Means don't be unemployed to me, O my servant. Don't be lazy. Follow what I ordered you to do. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever Prophet gave to you, follow it. إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. If you really love Allah, follow me. Allah loves you. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us the way to be good servant, good employee. So batala in bad characteristics is a bad characteristics in the self. So you have to struggle with your inner self in order to stop batala from ruining you. So what ash-shari' ash-shari' is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We say ash-shari' means the one who put the law of Islam, the Islamic law. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us the Islamic law, showed us the Islamic building, structure, foundation, economy, government, state, everything. So you are employed to that government, you are employed to that state, you are employed to that law, you are employed to that discipline. You are a subject to what you are employed to. You cannot say no When you say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله, you finish, you gave your initiation, you gave your bay'ah. You cannot pull your bay'ah out. When we say shahada, means we have accepted to work for that shahada. So don't be wasting your time and pull yourself out from that worshipness and say, I am unemployed now. You are employed. You are a subject because you have an agreement. When you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, you signed an agreement with Allah. You cannot, void that agreement. If you void that agreement, you will be asked. That agreement is there. And an agreement witnessed by Prophet and angels. Two angels and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, a contract being signed between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why in judgment day, Allah bring all these agreements, contracts, and say, that's my servant made an agreement with me. He said shahada. So send him to paradise. You kafir, unbeliever, you didn't do an agreement with me. So I'm leaving you. No mercy for you. Mercy for those who did agreement. On top of that, who did agreement and were working according to that agreement, Allah will give them higher and higher. He will raise them. They become officers. They become managers. They become directors. They become, executive director. They become chairman. Means Allah give them, raise them from one paradise to another paradise. Because they kept their, they respected the employer, and they kept, they believe that they are employee to that foundation, which is Islam. So that batala is a bad characteristics when we are not really responding to our employer, to our creator, to follow what he has instructed us to follow. Then the community collapse, and that's why you see recession. When there is no work, no one doing his job, everyone is fired. Why they fired? Because they didn't fulfill what the employer wants. In a company, they fire you because you are not working well. Allah is rich. It's not like a company in dunya, they fire you because they don't have money. Allah is telling you, I will not fire you. You are with me. Follow. But the instruction, I give you instruction. Don't waste your time in shopping centers. Don't waste your time in mall. Don't waste your time in movie theater. Don't waste your time in video. What is that? Videos at, what do they call it, video? At home. Don't waste your time following shaitan, bad desires. You want to go to the mall? You go, but for necessity. Taking your children out, giving them a nice dinner is okay. Raise them Islamically is okay. Give them some fun entertainment is okay. But don't waste it. Don't go beyond the limit. Keep remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are free at home, take your beats. لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله. Remember Allah. With every breath, as we explained 2 days ago, with every breath, remember Allah giving you that breath with His power, energy, Qadir, with His Qudra, Allah. Say, Ya Rabbi. You take a breath, say La ilaha illallah. You take in, inhale, La ilaha illallah. Exhale, La ilaha illallah. Inhale means remember Allah in every moment. That is the opposite of batala. That's the opposite of not doing anything, sitting and wasting your time and not being employed. Allah gave you an employment, fulfill that employment. He gave you a job, fulfill that job by worshipping Him. Al-Kibar. We explain Kibar? No. Al-Kibar is to be Kibriya, is from Kibriya, means from arrogance, from pride. Is different from Azama. Azama, we explained it last time. Or no, not yet, it's still here. So Kibar is, you think yourself above people. You think yourself higher than everyone. You don't like to sit with poor people. They are not of your class. You are elite. You are a high society. You must be only sitting with elite people. You see them, they go to some type of event. They have to wear special dress. You have to wear what? Special dress, doctor. They call it tuxedo, nice, a black dress, and it has to be from the back robe, and then you have here like a cross hanging on your neck, or like a tie, like a cross hanging, yeah? And sometimes this tie is like, if it is not a cross, they invented to be a cross. Everyone, but you have a tie like an animal, they pull you from your tie. Come! And if you don't have that tie or that small one, what you call that small one? Bow tie, they don't let you from the door. Is that? They say come, what you say? Formal dress. Allah never said to us, come formal dress. Allah said to us, come with formal inner dress. With your simplicity, come to me, my servant. With your humbleness, don't be mutakabbir, proud of yourself. Even you have the highest title in this dunya, is nothing. If I don't give you that title, no one can, you cannot get it from anyone. I am the one that give titles. And he gave title to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He gave title to all prophets. He gave title to Sahaba. He gave title to everyone he likes. From dunya, it's not title. If someone give you a title, there are in some countries they said you are a lord, you are a, I don't know what, you are what, they give you titles. What is that? It's nothing. If Allah gives it, then it is something. Al-izzatu lillah, wa li rasulihi, wa lil mu'mineen. Izza is what is that, Tahir? Honor is for Allah. For Prophet, he gave it to Mu'min. Allah said, Izza, honor, respect, dignity for Muslims, for Mu'min. But he didn't say Kibar. Al-Kibriya'u lillah. Kibar is only for Allah. No one can be mutakabbir except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means the one that he has the right to say, I am the proud one. I'm the top one. I'm the highest one. That's one who has the right to say that. Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went into Isra and Mi'raj, went into the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He came back and he never said anything except, Ya Rabbi, I am your servant. Abdullah, He was happy to be called Abd. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. Praise be to Allah to who took his servant Abd to his presence. He was humble. He was happy. He said, "The best time in all my life, from beginning to end, is when Allah calling me Abd." Abd, you know what's Abd? What Abd? Abd, really in Arabic, is more than servant, is slave. Prophet is happy to be anything in front of his, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't think yourself you are something, you are nothing. We are nothing. We must not have that kibar, that arrogance, pride in ourselves. Iblis had that pride. He said, "You created him from clay, from dirt. You created me from energy, from fire. I'm better than him. I'm not going to do sajda for him." For Adam. What happened? Kibar. What happened? What happened? Curse. Allah cursed him. So anyone has an atom of kibar in his heart, Allah will curse him. And if Allah curse us, because we are Muslim, we are mu'min, we are not like Iblis, "Ya Rabbi, forgive us." So Allah, his curse cleans us. Because we immediately repent. We ask, "Ya Rabbi, keep us informed to repent after every sin." Whenever you do a sin, there is a kibar behind it. Because how you do a sin? Why you do a sin? Because you are arrogant and proud of yourself that you veil your Lord. You cannot see him anymore. So you commit a sin. Sayyidina Yusuf, when she came and pulled him, امرأة العزيز تراود فتاها عن نفسه. She is asking him. تراود نفسها. تراود فتاها means she is trying to arouse his desire by doing some kind of movement. If Yusuf was seeing himself as the most beautiful, get that kibar in himself, he would have veiled his Lord and he would have committed this sin. But what he said? "No, Allah is seeing me. Oh Allah, if you do not protect me, I will fall." He remembered that the greatest is Allah. So Allah is seeing. So you, arrogant makes you not to see anyone above you. Pride, arrogant, no way. You are the highest. You know everything. You are on top of everyone. So means everything else, you see it like an ant, is nothing, garbage. So when you see everything garbage, nothing in front of you, means you will destroy what Allah, destroy what the belief that Allah put in your heart that you are a good Muslim. So at that moment of weakness, that will disappear because shaitan is playing with us. So kibar will end us in committing sin and not seeing our Lord and not seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a desire that Islam prohibited Muslims from carrying that characteristic. Kibar is to repel, to reject, to deny everything. You do not accept. You cannot accept. You are in a denial position. When kibar dress you, means you see yourself the best. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of promises, called everyone in his presence and he said, who am I and who are you? Prophets, they said, prophets, they said, you are our Lord and we are your servant. Prophets and Sahaba. Then, and the rest, they said, you are what you are, we are what we are. Because Kibar, they saw themselves, they saw their lights there. There was no sin there. They saw that power that Allah created them from. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. From Allah, we are to Allah and from Allah we go back. So they saw that light. وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي. Allah said for Sayyidina Adam, I blow in him my order from my power. Go to him, to Adam, make him to move. So if Allah gave that power, the kibar only for Allah, not for Adam. Adam is weak. He was not able to move without that power, that energy. So when Allah asked us, الْأَرْوَاحُ جُنُودٌ مُجَنَّدًا, in the day of when the spirits were in front of Allah, Allah create our atoms, زَرَّات بَنِي آدَم, and mentioned in Holy Quran that Allah put these زَرَّات in the back of Adam عليه السلام. تذكر الآية؟ So what happened is that Allah, when they refused, they denied that you are what you are and we are what we are. Allah threw them in Bahrul Ju'a, in the ocean of hunger. Because hunger, when you are hungry, what happened? Huh? Not only weak, you become, you have no more kibar. When Allah dump you in hunger for days and days, week and week, what you eat? Huh? What you will eat? Anything you find. What you can find? Garbage? That's easy. You remember in Lebanon when they in this when there was war there in the 80s and there was no food. You know what people were eating when they have a siege, you say, being surrounded, what you say? Siege, what the army surround. So what people were eating? Rats, mice, cats. You remember? There was no food, there was nothing to eat. They find a rat, they eat it. A dead rat also. More than garbage. Garbage, at least you can find some rotten food or rotten vegetables. Sheikh, they were eating rats and mice. So someone eat rat and mice from hunger, what's that mean? Any more kibar on him? Nothing, finish. Allah brought them down, humiliated them to a situation that he has said, Ya Rabbi, we believe in you. He pulled them out from the ocean of hunger. And he asked, who am I and who are you? Muslims at that time, they said, you are our Lord, we are your servant, your slave. They knew now that they are nothing. Because Muslims, prophets and Sahaba are, prophets are innocents. There is no sin on them. They don't commit sin. Sahaba, they are protected. Allah protect them. Normal people like us, we are sinners. We are weak. That's why he dumped us in, threw us in that ocean of hunger. So we came out, we believed now. He said, Ya Rabbi, you are our Lord, we are your servant. And that's why when you come in dunya, Muslims always one day, good, do something good, one day do something bad, they repent. They are a bit struggling between these both things, which is okay, alhamdulillah. Allah merciful. The non-Muslims, they said, you are what you are, we are what we are. Kuffar, unbelievers. And Allah left them. And that's why Muslim, it's very difficult to find a Muslim with kibar. There are Muslims, they have kibar in themselves. But not everyone. Unbelievers, they teach you to say, I'm proud of you. They tell you in schools, you say to yourself, you are proud of yourself. Is that what they tell you in school? Be proud of yourself. Oh, you are very good. You are good. You must be proud of yourself. They throw that, shaitan throw that word in their heart. They don't know what they are doing. But when you grow up, when you are proud of yourself, you tell your father, oh my father, I want to be independent. I don't want you to look after me when you become 16. You think that you are the, what's that, the genius of geniuses. You are Einstein. You leave and go. Is correct? Yeah, that's what happened. Correct, Steve?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. This is what they teach you here. That's okay? Not okay. It built up the bad characteristics instead of being surrendering to everyone. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be happy with what Allah gave to you. No, you become arrogant. You forget about your Lord. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala threw them, the Muslim came out and said, Ya Rabbi, in hunger, they said, Ya Rabbi, the hunger is the most difficult thing in dunya. Allah threw them in that ocean of hunger. That's why you cannot be hungry in dunya. It's always, it will torture you when you are hungry. And that's why you run to eat anything. May Allah protect us. And may Allah forgive us. Al-Riya, 11. الرياء الرياء is the show off, isn't it? To show yourself always that you did this, that he did that. You are happy of what you are doing. And you want everyone to know that I did this. And you must, on the contrary, see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has helped you to do that. It's not you that you did that. And that's why ar-riya means you are avoiding to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made me to do that, but you think that you did it by yourself. Like for example, I will give a small example, it's only to make it simple. Someone go to the doctor, he's sick, and the doctor prescribed for him a pill. And alhamdulillah, he is cured. He cannot say the doctor cured me. He has to say Allah cured me. If he say the doctor cured me, he made a hidden shirk. And if the doctors say I cured him, and he begin to say showing off to others, that is mean he is that doctor is trying to replace Allah's position. That he become the curer. Allah is the curer. Allah huwa shafi is not the doctor. The doctor is an instrument in Allah's will. So the doctor must not have that kind of showing off. Whatever he does it for Allah. Muslim, non-Muslim is helping anyone. Like for example, many people, they donate for masajid. You come at the end of the year, you find their names being hanging on the wall. As Sayyid Fulan Fulan, Al-Kareem, Al-Salih, Al-Mukhlis, Al-Abid. They don't know when someone donate to a mosque, they don't know what kind of petting him. They try to pet him to make him so happy with his donation that he wants his name to be seen by everyone. Who gave you that money? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah wants to take it, you have nothing. Allah is the owner. If you are giving, you are giving from Allah's money, not from you. So why are you putting your name there? For what reason? Showing off? That is riya. That is the meaning of riya. Means whatever you do, you want your name to be seen. Whatever you are trying, if you are doing something for the benefit of the community, you publicize your name, that I am doing this and I am doing that. That is not acceptable. That is riya. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us from falling into this hidden shirk. And we said that when in Surah Al-Kahf, there was one Sahabi that he likes to help people. He likes to do everything. But he likes his name to be mentioned. So when he do something good, he goes to Prophet or he goes to other people, he say, I did that. And Allah revealed that verse of Quran as we explained it last time. And it was explained by As-Suyuti. Why that verse of Quran was being revealed to Prophet ﷺ is not what they do they say about it, some other scholars of some narrow-minded scholar, when they say وَلَا أُشْرِكُوا بِرَبِّي أَحَدًا. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ, whoever wants really to meet, to be in Allah's presence, he must not come with riya. Allah is saying in Surah Al-Kahf, last verse of Surah Al-Kahf, don't come to me with riya. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ, who is requesting to come to Allah's presence, فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا, he has to do a good amal, a pious amal, a sincere amal, and Allah put a condition on it. When he does this amal, he said, وَلَا يُشْرِكُ بِرَبِّهِ أَحَدًا, and he must not. If you ask people today, they say, you must not make a partner to Allah, yushrik. But that is not correct. This is not the Arabic meaning of it. The correct meaning is what Imam Suyuti said in explaining that verse. He said, and Ibn Abbas explained that verse, the biggest, and Ibn Umar also, the biggest muhaddith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said that, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَ رَبِّي أَحْدًا, means if he is requesting Allah is saying to him, if you are requesting to see, to come to me, and to be in my paradise in judgment day, you have to do a good amal. But that good amal you must not show off. So what he said to him, وَلَا يُشْرِكُ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّي. Don't associate that amal to yourself. You have to associate it to me. That's why, وَلَا يُشْرِكُ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. Don't associate that amal except to me. Even you are doing it, it is me that I made it for you possible. So Allah, the last verse of Holy Quran is explaining al-riya, showing off. Don't show it off. So Prophet, when that verse was revealed, he called after that Sahabi and told him, yeah, don't, that's what Allah is saying. So riya is dangerous. Now it doesn't take you outside the range of Islam, no. But it is a bad characteristic. You must leave it. When you do amal, اعمل عملا مخلصا لوجه الله. We say do it for Allah only. Don't do it for anyone else. Don't do it even for yourself as if you are doing, associating yourself with Allah. You do it for Him. Don't even ask a reward. He reward you. He doesn't reward you. It's up to Him. Surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not doing it for return back. Many people now, they do something, they say, I'm getting my reward from Allah. Means you are doing it still for a return. There are higher friends of Allah, they are higher in understanding. They say, don't do any amal asking a reward. Do it. Allah wants to reward you or not. This is up to Him. Leave it to Him. He might give Allah without بغير حساب. Allah give with no account. So don't look at small returns. Look at His mercy. That's what you look for. The hidden shirk, as you are a Muslim and you do not accept association anyone, even yourself, with Allah, with your amal that you are doing good, so Allah wants to clean you. Because you are a Muslim, Allah doesn't want to take, when you die, Allah doesn't want to take your spirit. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Still in hidden shirk, Allah wants to clean you from that. So that hidden shirk appear in your body. Allah makes it appear in the body of the dead person as his spirit is being taken away. And that's why you see some people, they have a hard time in giving their breath out because of the cleansing process that going through them. That's why people, they sweat when they die. You are a doctor. How many people sweat when they die? Many people, they sweat when they die. When they sweat, they are seeing how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is merciful with them. How much they wear. They are trying to be in the way of Allah, but shaitan was playing with them. But they were repenting. And they seeing how much Allah is mercying them, they feel shy. They sweat. Allah is cleaning them. When you sweat, all your body, they say today, with this new technology, they say you have to run jogging, then all your veins open, you become like, your heart become, rejuvenate by sweating, running and sweating, is not? So sweating is a cleansing process. It cleans your inside. So people, when they die, they sweat. When they sweat, Allah is cleaning them from their sins. Muslims. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take that darkness away, that darkness of hidden shirk from yourself, from you, when you are passing from this dunya. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. We have honored a human being. With that honor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to honor us by cleaning us. He doesn't want mu'min, he doesn't want Muslim to come without cleansing process. Allah will clean us from riya, from all these bad characteristics, as long as we remember that we have signed a contract. When we signed that contract? In the day of promises. We said, you are our Lord, we are your servant. After he threw us in the ocean of hunger. For 70,000 years we were in that ocean. Hungry. 70,000 years, not one thing Allah gave to us. Darkness. Not only hungry from food. There is no food there. It is, he made us hungry from the food of knowledge. He threw us in darkness, not knowing anything. In dunya we get hungry from food. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us how much we are losing by throwing us and dumping us in that darkness. No knowledge, nothing. We've been separated from His presence. Hungry for His presence. Hungry for His love. Hungry for His beauty. Hungry for His mercy. Hungry for His patience. Hungry for His forgiveness. Hungry for every good, His beautiful names and attributes. Allah, separate us. So we don't want to be separated. May Allah keep us in His presence. May Allah keep us in paradise with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الفاتحة.